getting on the Chattooga Trail. GPS and another name. Elliot's back. I think that's probably what I'm going to try to do is see if I can hike to Elliot's ranch. The last time I came up this trail, once I got probably a little over halfway to Elliot's ranch, and the trail got real bad. There were pretty big trees down covering the trail that you had to crawl under, and it just made it difficult, especially with this big pack on. Oh man, we'll try. Alright, I am not going to hold this GoPro on my face the whole day. Let's see, it gets pretty steep right here. One of countless little camping areas. There's tons of these places on this river. Water's right there. This is a perfect camping spot, but there's another area over there. Really nice. There's a creek up here that runs into the Chattooga River. Once we get across that, trail really narrows down. For hikers, it's a good trail. It's right off the foothills trail. The thing about this trail though is, since it's not on the foothills trail, it's not as crowded. I'm using my GoPro right now. Well, it's actually not a GoPro, it's an 8-man. It's a $59 4-man version of a GoPro. That's alright with me. It takes pretty good video. The audio is not so good, but it's alright. Be careful up here. Some of these places get a little narrow where they're steep. It's gonna be hard to tell on the camera. We've gone almost a mile. 0.9. And it's easy. I get turned around right here with it. It starts opening up. And you've got these little trails that go off in all directions. It's really wet. We've gone 1.6 miles. Oh, look, now see, here we go. This is what I'm talking about. See, I've got to crawl under this thing. You gotta get low enough to get your feet under it. How narrow this gets. Be careful here. I think this is Bad Creek that I just crossed over. Across. Okay, this is a bad creek. Right. Made it. Bad creek. So here's a nice little campus right here. Here. That's not as bad. Man, everything is so wet up here. This is going to be a little bit of a challenge. out here, the trail is just looks like it freaking dies right here. Found another good spot that I might choose to camp in. And I like this one a little better than the other one because it's off the trail just enough. God, look at that fire pit. Wow, it's got a bench. Wood. That's what I'm trying to get around. Now it's busting my ass. Jeez. Trail has gotten really wet, really rocky. I'm not trying to get over this without slipping down one of these rocks right here. Fuck. Yeah. I hope my camera's still. I just did what I was trying not to do. These rocks are so slippery. Wow. Alright, so I just got to this little clearing. And this is why you do what you do here. Well, I'm thinking this is Elliot's Rock. This is where it is on the GPS. I don't know. My plan is to eat a quick snack and hike back about a mile to that last campsite. That was about 3.62 miles to Elliot Rock. So now I'm wondering, back to that big rock, I'm wondering if that's Elliot's Rock and it was just wrong on my GPS. It's just amazing how slick everything is. Yeah, this is a good one. Oh well. Pretty hazardous area here. I mean, so dang slick. Once you start sliding, you're done. And problem is, you're top heavy. I got to my campsite. 4.46 miles total. I'm at that site that I showed you before. Now I got my fence up. That thunder. So this is my setup here. That should stay pretty dry. So, there's my rope. Get my fingers in that tree, man. That's perfect. I should have done that the first time.
Water.
Okay, so I had to redo. I didn't realize how humid. I mean, it's so humid out here that the dryer lint's not even harvest fan lint. So I had to process some more wood, and I broke down some dry wood. Also, the wood down here on the bottom is a little bit damp, so that was that was hurting. So I'm gonna try this again. I'm no expert, but at the same time, conditions are pretty tough. I mean, it's got to be 80% humidity out here, more, really, really high. That's the third time I broke up some more wood, finer pieces. I'm running out of options here. Yeah, I tried to pull this apart. It's so humid. I mean, my hands are sweating so bad. That's part of the problem too, is everything I'm touching, I'm really kind of getting wet. Crazy. I'm getting really desperate now. Hopefully this works. I can explain what I'm doing. These things are hard to fight the humidity that's going on.
tried a flare.
Didn't even get a flare to light.
That's called camping in a rainforest.
Well, I finally got the fire going okay, but I gave up on it because it took me about almost an hour now, maybe 45, 50 minutes to get to that point. I just can't get anything to burn, but now it's hot enough to where it's kind of burning. I've had to blow it and just forever. I mean, it's just crazy. You know, and I'm no experienced backpacker, but I did come with a lot of different ways to make fire.
Came with a lighter, which I couldn't even get the branch. I couldn't even get my lighter to work, hardly. I came with my ferro rod and these, the lint. Dryer usually works pretty good. I came with a flare. I couldn't even get my flare to work. And the thing that worked was the stormproof matches. I had to go through about maybe all but two. And I just kept beating them in there. And eventually it lit. Enough to where I was able to have a little bit of a flame to work with. And it just took forever from that point to keep building it. That's the hardest fire I've ever had to make. The humidity level, the fact that it's so wet, everything, I'm in a rainforest. You know, it's, I honestly didn't think I was gonna get this fire going, so it wasn't a big deal. It was warm, and I had a stove, so I wasn't, you know, it's not like I needed it for heat, but I do like to have a fire.
Oh, I just poured my water and my chili. It's gonna take about 10 or 15 minutes for it to rehydrate. It's a little watery, I put too much water in it, but that's alright. It's gonna be good. Corn chips, Tabasco. Fire's still going.
Everything is soaked. Thunderstorm is still here. Rain is pouring. And I'm just waiting for this rain out right now. I got a pack to go. I'm soaked. Everything I have is soaked. My sleeping bag soaked. My hammock soaked. Thank you.
So I'm back in my backyard. It's the next day. Ended up having to leave in the middle of the night. When the thunderstorm hit, blowing the rain all up in under my tent, my tarp, I really needed to have a tent in order to survive that situation properly. It was unbelievable. I was soaking wet. Water got everywhere, as you can see in the video. I just didn't stand a chance, and there's no way I could dry off. So I had to go. I wasn't going to stay out there the entire night dripping wet. The problem was I had to pack all my stuff, and it was pouring rain, lightning, and I had to hike 3.5 miles to get back to my truck. So that's what I did. It was so dark out there, but luckily I had enough flashlights. It was so hard just trying to figure out where I was going. I got turned around a couple of times and got off the trail once and had to turn around and go back. It was a little scary. I knew I'd figure it out, but you know, my whole thing was I was just soaked to the bone. And I wanted to get dry. I did pass another hiker with two dogs, his wife and his daughter, and they were camping in a spot closer to Burrells Ford Road where my truck was, and they said 3 trees fell right around their campsite. So, and then when I left to come, once I got in my truck, I was just shocked at how many trees I was seeing down. There were the forecasters called for 20% chance of rain, which is why I brought the tarp. Otherwise, I probably would have brought my tent. If I had brought my tent, I would have been fine. It's a little bit heavier, though, so that's why I didn't take it. But anyway, all in all, it was a great trip until the end. But still, you know, it was an adventure getting out of there. So I got home probably about 10 after 12, maybe 12:15, something like that. One thing I could have done different is with the tarp, I could have had it lower. I probably should have had that tarp much lower so that my hammock was right up near the top of it. So anyway, hope you guys enjoyed it. Thanks.